So here we are on a hot and humid day, Cruisin Creek. Rosalie and I are on an adventure. I don't know what type, good, bad or otherwise, but we're looking for something to do. What do you got to say, Rosalie?
We are doing lure fishing right now. I have already gotten mine into a knot.
Yeah, it's not hard to get knots in when you're lure fishing. Once you cast out, check your line before you start reeling back in. Make sure there's no knots sitting there. They have to be sorted straight away. Righto, darling, we'll go back and start casting again, eh?
Yep.
Well, we got chased out of Cruisin Creek because, well...
Midges.
How many midges? Shitloads!
Too many.
Hey. So we're going to go and try Causeway. Rosalie's got bites all over her hand that look like a bit of a
circle.
Puzzle. Join the dots.
Yeah.
I've got a few on my hands that I'm busy rubbing while I'm talking to you. So, Causeway, here we come. All right. And here we are in beautiful little Emu Park. It's not the speediest town in the world. Driving past the Anzac Memorial, we'll come back here for a look. You see more of it right there in front of us.
Yeah, that place is interesting.
And that takes us up to the singing ship, the scene of the crime. I got married here to my beautiful wifey, and it was absolutely lovely. We'll do a bit of a U-turn and park over on the other side. Rosalie and I might go for a bit of a walk.
I was there at the wedding when I was about 6 months old, but Liliana was not born yet.
Yes, Rosalie was there. Mum and I done the naughty. And here we are, scene of the crime. This is where Narelle and I got married. Over there beside that singing ship. We'll wander on with our walk and have a look around the Anzac Park. The singing ship is a monument to Captain James Cook. Without him, we wouldn't be in Australia. As much as he had a bad reputation in some ways, hey, again, without him, we wouldn't be here. Singing ship. Sorry, talking through a mask. Probably don't need it on, but I got it on. This is other people around. It's beautiful here, I love it. It's just that beautiful, breezy little town. Just looking out towards the islands from Emu Park. The waves just rolling in. We're just below high tide here at the moment. This is still on the Anzac walk. We're looking at the back of that horse monument up there at the moment. I'll show you from the front shortly. This is a really well done path done by the Emu Park Council to celebrate Anzac Day, our Anzacs. It's been here a few years now. I'd love to come down here for an Anzac morning, but yeah, it's an hour from home and I don't like it now, about 2 o'clock in the morning. We'll go and have a look in this here little shack. I know it's got a lot of stuff about it.
My brain's not good for anything.
Righto. This is the inside of the shack that I just showed you. There's a lot of information about Australia. It goes to war, 1914, Gallipoli 15, David Whiting 15, 94 to 15, Harold Tooker 93 to 80. See, there's some of the older guys, well, 93 to 80, he had a 1893 to 80. He had a long life, saw some unfortunate things. There's the Battle of Somme, William Ahern, 1887 to 1967. So, the campaign in Flanders, Dudley Salmon, Alexander Edmonston, which is an interesting name. I grew up around a family named Edmonston. This is, alright, more of the centre here. All theatres of war, some certain characters out of the war. This is an exceptionally well done memorial, in my opinion. Oh, and that's really hard to take looking out there. But it's Rosalie.
Nurses.
And yes, the heroes. Often not thought of. Nurses. The ladies getting the messages through. The home front. The final days. Commemorations and the summary of the war, I guess, and a lot of it's not good. The artist responsible for doing the artwork here, some on the floors. The nurses and the ladies for getting the messages through. Some of these are local to us, and a couple of them lived to near 100 or 100 years old, which is for what they seen, what they done. Yeah, pretty cool. There's the rest of the memorial down there. It's quite cool. The sun comes up behind it and you can see the sun through it. Never know, might try to get back here in the morning. We'll see what the weather's like and where I end up. And if the photography is wobbly, I'm very sorry. As you can see, the sign is clear with the guys painted on it. I hope you can see that. And then when the sun comes up behind it in the morning, I believe it's supposed to look very nice. We will try to get back here for it. This is the front of the horse I was talking about before. Rosalie reminded me to come back and show you. There's quite a few of these little monuments. Let's see if I can find some more. So yeah, here's another one of the monuments. This old memorial spread out over probably 200 or 300 meters. It's really nice. I've said that before, I'll say it again. A lot of respect shown for the Anzacs. Yeah, I love it. heading out of alright, we're away. We're heading out of Emu Park, heading towards Roslyn Bay. We'll go down there and throw in some bait for a while until it gets so hot to do it. Then we'll go and find a shady tree. This is the middle of the highway coming out of Emu Park. Nothing exciting. It's only a short drive to where we turn off down along the beachfront. Once we get there, we'll go in along the beachfront until we reach across the causeway, lake area, until we reach Roslyn Bay. We'll go in there, hook some prawns on the end of a bit of a fishing line with a hook and throw it in and see what we can catch. Tide's on its way out now, so we've probably got an hour of fishing before it's time to give up. Okay, we're coming up to the Roslyn Bay turnoff, scenic highway they called it. We'll turn in here. Capricorn Coast Beaches. This isn't a bad area, I'm not sure I'd like to live here, but it's better than living in Rockhampton, so well, in front of us used to be an old seashell, the white whale, and now it is just a white whale. Seashell display, seas aquarium type thing, closed years ago. Unfortunately, the white whale's just sitting there. If I owned it, I'd turn it into an Airbnb in an instant. Alright, this is the Kinka Beach area. Over the sand hills in front of us, eh? To the right is where the ocean is. Anyway, it's shallow out here and you got to walk through the sand dunes to get to it. Low tide, it goes out a couple of hundred metres probably. There's no real interest in me, to me there, but yeah, it's alright. Nice little area along the front here. Some of these houses have probably cost 10 or 20,000 in the 60s. Now going for $500,000. There was an old shack that went for sale down here recently, actually sold for over $400,000. It would be a nice spot, no doubt about that. Bit of a prime spot in the front of a cyclone though. You're the first one it's going to hit before it reaches anyone else. But, don't get cyclones here that often, not real bad. We do get them, of course. But, anyway. Alright, now we're coming up to the Causeway Lake area. This is, just a little bridge that they've put across it. I don't know if you can see it in the camera there out to the left. There's a big lake out there. Pretty well catch anything in it. Mangrove jack, barramundi, bream, flathead, shark, crocodile, Yeah, you can pretty well catch anything in there. I've never had a great amount of success there, so we'll drive on by to the next spot. Come back to it later if desperate, never know your luck. Can't catch a fish unless you got your line in the water. Just a little bit more of the scenic highway. There's some really nice houses here overlooking the ocean. Some little shacks that are worth a fortune. To be honest, if I was to buy a house here, I'd prefer one of the little shacks. They have more character, I think.
And with the little shacks, you can make them nice and colourful, and that's just like, I feel how shacks are just very well known as well.
Exactly. Up here, we're going to go through a little twisty bit on the scenic highway. It's about the only twisty bit. This road's pretty good.
Not that bumpy.
It's pretty well looked after. A few patches and so on, but it's all low speed, 60 km/h limit. A lot of turnoffs coming in from the sides. That's it, the only little twisty bit on it that you have to hit your brake for.
Not like Mount Morgan.
No, Mount Morgan range is a bit worse.
Yeah.
We'll go in here and show you this little trailhead parking area thing. I guess trailhead's more of an American term. But you go in here and nice little pet camping area. That hill up in front of us. There's a big walk that goes up around there. We've done it. I'm too old and fat for that crap.
It says no camping.
It's Bluff Point, they call it. You're not supposed to camp there, but I know people do. Last time I came down here, there was an old mate pulled up here camping. I seriously don't think, if anyone came along, what are they going to do? They're going to book you and send you on your way, who cares? But yeah, it's a nice little area just to pull up. Oh mate, here going for a walk. I'd love to go back over there if I was younger, fitter. My knees didn't hurt so much. I'm full of excuses, so I won't be doing that again. Even the dunnies here get done up with art. Nearly any dunnies along the flat, along this highway, is done up with some type of art. All scenic for the tourists. Here we go, not far to Roslyn Bay now. Turn into Roslyn Bay. There's quite a few boats go out of here. This spot in front will be our camping area tonight, maybe. Most likely. The Vincent Edward Drive. Vincent Edward Jones Drive, sorry. Something like that.
It's also a memorial.
We'll go for a quick look around at the Keppel Bay Marina area. Spoil Sports won't let us fish around here because all the pompous gets in their boats. But, anyway, they own the property, it's our choice as to what we can do and what we can't. And there's a few clowns that have hurt things around here. No respect for other people's property. So I guess you can't blame them. We'll go into that part of it, the boat ramp part, when we're on our way back. What were you saying, Rosalie?
I'm showing the colourful houses.
The houses?
Yeah,
the colourful. Oh, yeah. This is where the rich folk live down here, in their flash homes with their all mouldy colours. I think they must be trying to make it look Mediterranean, I'm assuming. We can't Bayside Way, okay. We'll go down here for a look. They give us the privilege of being able to drive down here. Whee! But again, we have to respect the choices. I don't know what those apartments would be worth, but more than what my bank balance is, isn't it? Anyway, I'm flat out going to the corner shop, let alone buying one of them. You'd think for the area, I'd look after this piece on the left, here a bit better. Green it up and look after the gardens, but anyway, what do you reckon, eh?
Yeah.
Here we go. I don't even know if we're really allowed to even park down here. I doubt it, someone will whinge. Marina patrons only, well we can't go in there. But as you can see by the boats in between the trees. Sorry, not getting out to take shots here because someone will no doubt whinge. I'll try and get into a better spot so you can get some boat shots. If you're wandering around this area, take notice. Look at the grass that's overgrown. And this is not a complaint about the length of the grass. This is, look at your feet when you're walking around this area. Safety first. If you're in that grass, in amongst all those trees and so on, please wear boots and long pants. Because there's brown snakes, taipan snakes, there's every type of snake that's in this area, around here. There are snakes here that will kill you in about 20 minutes, like as in a taipan. So look, decide to do the right thing. Safety first. It's for your own good. This is where all the rich folk keep their boats. Roslyn Bay Marina. Us poor folk really aren't around down here much. There's a shop in there where you can buy overpriced coffee and a feed. They can make a fortune from someone else, not from me. Right here in front of us, that's the Coast Guard over there. The police just over here to the left. It's a lovely area here. Yep. Sorry, didn't mean to show you the car park. Someone there netting for bait. Couple of them throwing nets. That's cool. Throwing nets to get bait, yeah, yeah. Until he comes right up beside you and throws out while you're fishing. Right where you're fishing. That's when they're ignorant assholes. Looking after themselves and not caring about anyone else. Right, we'll go back around to the harbour now. Unfortunately, we'll probably get stuck. There's been a few charter boats coming in here lately, and they hook up to the harbour, to the jetty, and stay there for a couple of weeks at a time. We might get a good spot, we might not. They're paying customers, and we're doing this for free. So we can't really complain about it again. We just put up with it and put our line in where we can fit. Survey down here, reasonably priced. Everyone goes for their fuel before they go out. Ice is good there, baits. Oh God knows, the bait, I wouldn't buy bait from them. I wouldn't buy bait from anyone out of a freezer, because it's all crap. Go buy from a local seafood joint's better. Might cost a bit more, but at least your bait's in better quality. The Keppel Island Ferry's over here on the left. At Pier 1 or whatever they want to call themselves. Constable Plod. He's down here. In the time I've been here, I've only ever seen him. I've been coming here quite a bit. They've never ever come near me. Good thing, don't like cops. Don't care if you like, don't like that opinion. Damn, that's nice. Big catamaran with a shallow tri-hole centre. Lovely. Alright, so this is one of the boat ramps that you can go to. It's a nice little area. Safe area for putting in. A couple of lovely little Coast Guard boats there. I'd like one with the inflatable on the side. Man, that'd be lovely to go out on. Hello, they're getting lunch delivered to them, or breakfast. There's some more big buildings. Wouldn't mind hiring a room up there one night just to wake up and see the sunrise. The cooler's getting a bit of work done on it. Kicking back now, that's a nice boat.
I like its name.
You would not see me for a week at a time, on weeks at a time on that. I'd go out there and camp on the ocean. We got Roslyn Bay Fisherman's Market. There's some really nice stuff in there. Yeah, that's a lovely dinghy. Marine Research, that sounds nice. Well, I wish I was a smarter boy when I was younger. Ah, here we go, talking about the cops. Right here in front of us. Don't know what he's up to and don't really care. Charter boat there, it's been there for a couple of weeks. No doubt getting it out, right? So, we'll park here. See the Constable Plod's up there. I'm going to park down an area where he's going to come along and book me for no good reason. And this will do here. Yeah, I might pull forward a bit. That's if that man gets out of my way. And that'll stop any dipshit parking in front of me. This is Roslyn Bay, one of the charter boats that's been coming in lately, the Canimbla. Lovely big boat. We're tide going out at the moment, still fairly high tide. This is our fishing wagon, the old territory. And our little trailer. Tonight's home away from home. The door will be up, the fans will be on, and we'll be down there in that lovely little beach area, I'm hoping. Anyway, time to go wet a line. Well, we went fishing in the harbour. Found out that if you get caught camping here, it can cost you up to $1,500 a night if you're here in a van. Just thought I'd bring you down and show you the harbour a little bit. I know this is all out of the vehicle, but sorry. If you get caught camping here, that's 10 penalty points. 10 penalty points will cost you $1,500 to sleep here for the night. So whatever you do, don't come down here in a caravan or a camper trailer. You'll be in the shit. I just had it explained to me that if, I ain't say by who, other than they're related to the Roslyn Bay. If you're caught camping, sleeping in your vehicle, well, you're only here waiting for the tide to change so you can go fishing. And that's what you tell the man, and he's most likely going to agree with you and walk away. He said, for the penalty units, whatever you do, if you go to court, plead not guilty. That's all you gotta do. Go in there, explain yourself. You're camping in a vehicle, you're tired, you can't continue on, or you're waiting for the tide to change to go fishing. This little area where we are now, there's a bit of a walk up over the hill there, which I done years ago. Not doing it again. Old and lazy, but anyway, besides that, unfortunately a lady fell to her death there not long ago. So rest in peace to that poor lady. It's and condolences to her family. On the right there is a really good restaurant. I've unfortunately never been able to afford to go to it. Beaches, it's called. I'm told it's quite nice. Some units there. Roslyn Bay Resort. I'd love to come and spend a weekend down here, but anyway, again, when the finances allow. To be honest, I should have went to the toilet before coming down here. Alright! Lunch is done and dusted. It's as hot as all hell and humid. So we're going to find a camp until this afternoon, and we'll hit the harbour with some prawns. See if we can catch something in the harbour this afternoon, tonight. And then we'll go and find somewhere to camp. Somewhere about 10 o'clock or so, hopefully. Maybe later. Heading back towards Ruslan Bay, along the scenic highway from between Yeppoon and Ruslan. We'll catch up with you later. Here we are, camped down beside the highway going into Ruslan Bay. Damn, I make some mistakes. I think we'll call this one Ruff's Gutz Cruisin. There's honestly some of the mistakes I've made in the camera work, but hey, we're all human. I'm no expert at this, and this is just for a bit of fun.
Now, just for the minute, go back up towards the harbour. Yeah, we'll come back down here again soon. It's not very hard to set up. And it's getting close to when I can go back fishing again. We're past the hottest part of the day. It's now 10 past 4. And probably another hour, it'll be alright to go fishing. We shall see. It'll be low tide, but can't catch anything unless there's a line in the water, like I said before, so we'll put a line in the water. Never know your luck. You can catch good bream down here, flathead, salmon, a few different things you can catch in here, mackerel, I believe. I think that's what I caught one day. Anyway, get back to you soon.
You'll find some interesting rock formations around this area. I believe it was volcanic here, but the angle that they're shooting up at and that little bit, the way it's washed out with the weather, and over here we have a different angle altogether. Yeah, I'll take you out the front and show you. As you can see, up to the top, again with all the angles and the washed out areas. This is just out the front of Ruslan Bay, looking towards the islands over there, around the breakwall. It's fairly obvious by all the square concrete blocks. So we've moved down to the Causeway Lake area. Blah blah blah. Anyway, it's at low tide at the moment. We're just kicking back, waiting for it to get a bit cooler. It's past 4 o'clock. What is it, Rosalie? Hot or not?
It's warm, and it is 5 o'clock.
5 o'clock. Yes, it's bloody warm at the moment. We'll go back to the harbour shortly after it gets a bit darker. Probably about 6 o'clock or so. Catch you then. So, I've been fishing for hours, and all I've got is this one poor, lonesome, sad little grunter.
Which I identified first.
She did. So what we need to do is get a hook out of this poor little bugger.
send him back. Because I'm going to come back here in 12 months and eat that bastard when he gets bigger. Harder. So, the second small fish in 10 minutes. This one's a tiny little finger mark.
I've never seen him before.
No, I haven't caught one for a long time. But he's healthy, so we'll send him back. Unit, shot you. You know, in some of these fishing programs, they actually kiss the fish.
Gone.
So, third breed, bream, bit bigger. We'll get him off and send him back home.
Yep.
I don't know why you're taking these, but okay.
He is actually slightly bigger than the other brim, I think.
Okay, they're getting bigger. They're getting bigger.
You're getting bigger as the night goes on.
You can, but you'll probably get...
Dad has caught another fish.
Probably get kicked out. What's this one? Whoop.
Well, and he's on the ground.
What is he?
I think he's a grunter.
Little grunter, I think.
Oh, yep, another one.
Come here, buddy. Don't fucking hurt me.
Come on, dude. Are you kissing Dad's shirt? Okay.
Yeah, little grunter. That's what he is. Barely see the...
Got another bream.